안녕하세요. 오늘 또 만나게 돼서 반갑습니다. 바쁜 시간에도 이렇게 여러분도 참석해 주셔서 너무 감사하고요. 일곱 번째 웨비나입니다. 20번의 웨비나 중에서 7번째 하고 있습니다. 여러분들 많이 참석해 주시고 앞으로도 더 많이 응원해 주시면 감사하겠습니다. 이번 웨비나는 갈갈이 CD에서 스폰서를 쓰고 여성회에서 주최하고 있습니다. 여러분 많은 분들이 수고로서 진행되는 거기 때문에 많이 부족하기도 하고 또 원하는 바가 다 이루어지지 않더라도 여러분들 항상 뒤에서 응원해 주시고 함께해 주시면 좋겠고요. 이것을 위해서 수고하시는 우리 소피아, 오샤, 페라, 수진 안 보이지만 뒤에서 많이 수고하고 있습니다. 여러분들 많이 응원해 주시고 함께해 주시면 너무 감사하겠습니다. Thank you, everyone. This is a busy time, but you still can attend with us. I really appreciate it. This webinar is another excellent. We can utilize our lives. I think this OSHA will be give you so many different ideas and information. So I hope everybody enjoyed it. And please join with us and enjoy it. This webinar is sponsored by Calgary City and Korean Women's Association and do that. Behind the scene is a lot of people helping us to do that, especially Chrissy, which is Sujin and Sophia, Vera, and speaker, especially OSHA. And thank you so much, every one of you. And without you guys, I don't think we can able to do it. And before I introduce OSHA, I don't want to introduce OSHA. Maybe she can do herself. And I'll hand it to OSHA. And everybody enjoyed the last 1 hour or so. If you have any questions, and you can ask and using for the chat or question and answer part of it, as well as the next webinar, please join with us. And you can just check our women's group's website, and you will get a lot of information. So thank you so much, OSHA. That's all yours.
Thank you, Anna. Thank you so much for having me. What an honor and a pleasure to be here. I've been doing this for over 10 years, but I was just telling Farah and Sophia, this is my first time working with a translator to deliver a presentation to a non-English, necessarily English-speaking community. So I'm very, very excited to work with Sophia tonight too, and to go back and forth. My name is Orsha Magyar, and I'm the founder and the CEO of Neurotrition Inc. I'm a neuroscientist, a brain scientist by formal education, and now I'm also a nutritional consultant. And my team and I work with clients who struggle with different brain neurological conditions and various mental health conditions to help optimize their brain and mental health using nutrition as our primary tool. I love brain health. I love nutrition. And my biggest love is food. I love to eat. So we bring everything together, neuroscience, nutrition, and brain food for optimizing the brain and mental health. And I think the last year and a half with COVID has been so difficult on everybody's brain and mental health that everyone hopefully will learn something tonight and something they can take home and benefit to impact their overall mental wellness.
그의 이름은 Orsha Magyar이고 그는 Neurotrition Inc.의 설립자이자 회장입니다. 오늘 그의 고객의 두뇌 및 정신 건강 문제를 해결하는 데 도움이 되도록 팀이 사용하는 주요 영양소 5가지에 대해 알려드리려고 합니다.
So there's me before COVID, when I looked a lot different. My hair was done and shorter and I was still wearing makeup. So I look a lot different now, but that's okay. I did both my undergraduate and my graduate work at UBC in neuroscience. And I started my work with the brain studying epilepsy. And then through my graduate career in academics, I then looked at the neural underpinnings of anxiety. And I love the brain, but I was in academics for over 10 years. And somewhere along the way, I started to really think that maybe for some people, there had to be another answer to their condition besides only medication. So I, in my 10 years in neuroscience, received no education in nutrition or any lifestyle modalities. I didn't even learn about exercise, nothing about how it could impact brain and mental health. So when I, on my own, started to do research, I started to learn that nutrition could help brain and mental health. And I was so excited and I was so intrigued. That's what made me go back to school, leave academics, go back post-grad to study nutrition and create my company, Neurotrition Inc.
그녀는 UBC에서 행동신경과학 학사 학위와 신경과학 석사 학위를 받았습니다. 그녀는 먼저 간질을 연구한 다음 불안의 신경 기반을 연구했습니다. 모든 사람의 유일한 해결책이라는 생각과 씨름하기 시작했습니다. 뇌 및 정신 건강 문제는 약물이었습니다. 그녀는 분명히 다른 무언가가 있음을 알고 사람들을 도울 수 있다고 생각했습니다. 10년 동안 학계에서 뇌를 연구했지만 그녀는 그의 대학 교육을 받지 못했습니다. 다양한 신경학적 또는 심리적 상태에서 영향이 가능한 역할이 있습니다. 그녀는 우리가 먹는 음식이 역할을 한다고 그것을 알기 시작했을 때 놀랐습니다. 그래서 11년 전에 Neurotrition을 만들었습니다.
My vision from day one, 11 years ago, when I started this company, and it was just me and one chef. Now there's 25 people on my team. But from day one, when I began, my vision has always been to spark and spread the brain food revolution. I want everybody to understand what the science is saying about how nutrition influences how you feel, how you think, and how you behave. In this box, I've shown you what are some of the types of conditions that my team and I work with, for which science says nutrition can play a positive role. We work with depression, anxiety, memory and concentration issues. I work with a lot of clients who suffer from high stress, and we help them fight back against the effects of stress with nutrition. I work with sleep disorders. I work with, those are the mental health side. And then in the neurological side of things, my team and I work with multiple sclerosis, Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, head injury, and migraine. We also work with children. I have a pediatric practitioner who works with me, and we see children who struggle with anxiety, bipolar disorder, pediatric epilepsy, and autism spectrum disorder. And then in the winter, we're launching a new program called Sprouts for little babies, age 0 to 3, where we're going to really try and make a difference and catch signs and symptoms early when they're still little before it moves into these kinds of more serious conditions.
우리의 비전은 내식품 혁명을 촉발시키고 확산시키는 것이다. 왜냐하면 과학은 우리에게 영양분이 어떻게 느끼고 생각하고 행동하는지 알려주기 때문입니다. 그들이 보는 클라이언트 유형은 다음과 같습니다. 우울증, 불안, 집중력 저하, 기억력 저하, 자세히 생각 못함, 스트레스, 피로증, 불면증, 자폐증, 스펙트럼 장애, 다발성 경화증, 파킨슨병, 알츠하이머병, 머리 부상, 하고 편두통이 있습니다. 그들은 스트레스와 앰프에 대한 네 가지의 전문 소화과 프로그램에서 아이들과 함께 일합니다. 불안 소화 간질, 양극성 장애 및 앰프 자폐 스펙트럼 장애가 있습니다. 그들은 이번 겨울에 새로운 프로그램인 0에서 3세를 위한 새 프로그램을 가지고 있습니다. 이 프로그램에서는 초기 징후 및 증상과 함께 나중에 장, 면역 및 뇌 질환의 위험 요소를 해결하기 위해 노력을 합니다.
Brain health, especially during these really difficult times in our world, the last year and a half is really weighing big on people's minds. People are starting to think about what can they do to improve their brain and mental health. And food affects everything. Food affects your brain development from the time you're in the womb, in utero. It affects your brain and mental health throughout your entire life, And it even, science tells us, affects how your brain is going to age and how our minds can age gracefully if we fuel our brains with optimum nutrition. But it becomes very difficult and controversial sometimes to know what are the best nutrients for my brain. And that's the goal of tonight, is I want to teach you my favorite five nutrients based on the evidence and the research that can help you through common, everyday, familiar foods, help you boost your brain and mental health naturally.
요즘 내 건강은 매우 중요합니다. 그리고 영양 섭취를 돕는 것은 많은 사람들의 마음에 있습니다. 뇌의 발달, 뇌의 노화, 정신건강, 음식은 모든 것에 영향이 있습니다. 그렇다면 여러분이 먹어야 할 뇌와 정신건강에 가장 좋은 영양소는 무엇일까요? 과학에 따르면 Nutrition RX의 주요 제품인 5개가 있습니다.
So here's our first one. Yeah. You can go back if you want, Sophia, to the picture. So this is a picture I took close up of a walnut because I don't know if you noticed, but it looks quite like a brain. So I love walnuts. They're very good brain food and they even look like a brain. The research in nutritional neuroscience, so how food affects your brain and mental health, really began around 1980 with looking at omega-3 fat. So that's where the science started in this neurotrition area. And specifically, scientists found that people who lived in parts of the world where they ate more fish suffered from less depression. Then these scientists looked at these people's blood and they found that people who were not depressed had higher levels of these special omega-3 fats in their blood. And on the contrast, people who were more seriously depressed were found to be deficient in these omega-3 fats. So that's where the science started, 1980.
오메가3 지방은 영양과 뇌에 대한 연구가 80년대에 시작된 것입니다. 과학자들은 생선을 더 많이 먹은 사람들이 우울증, 그런 다음 그들은 혈액에 더 높은 수준의 오메가3가 있다는 것을 발견했습니다. 결핍된 사람들은 더 심각한 우울 증상을 보였습니다.
So I always tell people, please, you don't want your brain to be skinny, okay? You want a healthy, chubby brain. That's very important. You need your brain to be 60% fat. And a quarter of that, 25% of this fat, needs to be omega-3s. The two important ones are EPA and DHA. So I put together two lists here for you. On the left side, you can see that the highest sources of the omega-3s, EPA and DHA, are found in fish, but not all fish. These are my favorite brainy food fish, wild salmon, black cod, halibut, trout. These can be quite expensive. So I also like to include some more accessible, lower price point, smaller fish like sardine, anchovy, and mackerel. Now, if you're wondering why this list, how did I make this list? It's made because these are the fish that are the highest in omega-3, highest in calcium, and highest in vitamin D. Now on the right column, if you have an allergy to fish, or some people just don't like the flavor of fish, that's okay. Or if they're vegan, then you're going to get your omega-3s from plant-based foods. It's going to be a different type of omega-3 called ALA, and you can find these in various nuts and seeds, such as hemp, chia, flax, pumpkin, walnut. But I always want to encourage people to buy raw nuts and seeds, not roasted, not added salt or sugar or anything like that. And I also encourage you to try nut butters and seed butters too for these healthy fats.
당신은 마른 두뇌를 원하지 않습니다. 여러분의 뇌는 60%의 지방입니다. 그리고 이 지방의 25%는 오메가3, EPA, AA, 코사펜타엔산과 DHA입니다. 여기에 있는 생선 목록은 다량의 오메가3 지방과 높은 비타민 D, B, 칼슘을 기준으로 작성되었습니다. 예를 들면 연어, 흑돼고, 큰 넙치, 송어, 멸치, 정어리, 그리고 고등어가 있습니다. 근데 열한 물고기 중 일부는 값이 비쌀 수 있으므로 작은 물고기, 정어리, 멸치, 고등어를 권장합니다. 물성 생선 알레르기가 있나요? 오메가3 ALA를 대량 통로로 가져오려고 하십니까? 그러면 삼베씨, 찌아씨, 아마씨, 호박씨하고 호두씨를 드시면 됩니다. 근데 견과류와 씨앗의 경우 지방을 유지하기 위해 볶지 않는 상태로 구입하십시오.
Now, if you're looking to supplement, there's a few things that I need to teach you. Which one is the best for your brain? The best one for your brain, health, and mental health are EPA and DHA. Because science tells us that up to 80% of us have a problem converting the ALA from the vegan sourced fats into EPA and DHA. So my number one suggestion for you, if you want to supplement, is a fish oil that will provide EPA and DHA. If you don't like fish or you're allergic, your next best choice is a plant-based algae, which is a sea vegetable. It will also give you EPA and DHA. If those don't appeal to you, then the third option is taking ALA, like using flaxseed, chia, those things from my previous list. But then you also need to take a multivitamin daily to help the conversion.
불행히도 과학에 따르면 우리 중 80%가 ALA, 식물성 오메가3 식품 공급원에서 발견됨을 EPA 및 DHA, 뇌 건강에 필요함으로 전환하는데 어려움을 겪는다고 합니다. 따라서 두뇌에 이 건강한 지방을 원한다면 현명하게 선택해야 합니다. 생선 기름은 가장 쉬운 방법입니다. 조류는 EPA 및 DHA의 식물성 공급원입니다. 아마시유와 종합 비타민을 복용하여 전환을 도울 수도 있습니다.
Number two, B vitamins. This is a close-up picture of a piece of a Swiss chard, and it kind of looks like neurons or brain cells to me, so I really liked this photo. B vitamins are the number one category of vitamin for overall nervous system support.
비타민 B는 아마도 신경계의 건강을 위한 가장 중요한 비타민 계열일 것입니다.
The B vitamins, in fact, are so important for your brain that your brain uses active ATP to transport each B vitamin across the blood-brain barrier. The blood-brain barrier is simply a series of chemicals in the brain that tell your brain cells what is allowed to come in and what must stay out. So your brain uses energy to really make sure that these B vitamins get into the brain. The best options for B vitamins are going to be plants, especially dark green leafy vegetables. That's the number one way to get your B vitamins. You can also get it from some fruits, some vegetables. If you eat meat, those animals ate those plants. The one thing that's important to note here is vitamin B12 is very difficult to obtain if you are plant-based, if you're a vegan person, because B12 is found in meat, fish, eggs. So if you're plant-based, you need to make sure every day that you're eating sea vegetables, algae, and we also recommend that you supplement B12 if you are vegan.
비타민 B는 뇌에 매우 중요해서 각각의 비타민은 혈액 내 장벽을 가로질러 활발하게 운반됩니다. 혈내 장벽은 뇌 세포에 들어갈 수 있는 것과 차단해야 하는 것을 결정하는 뇌의 일련의 화학 물질입니다. 비타민 B는 매우 중요하기 때문에 우리 몸의 에너지를 사용하여 비타민이 체내에 흡수되도록 합니다. 각각의 비타민 B는 다른 역할을 하며 우리는 식물을 많이 섭취하기를 원합니다. 비타민 B12는 고기, 유제품, 계란에서 발견되기 때문에 채식주의자로서 얻기가 어렵지만 해조류에서도 얻을 수 있습니다. 우리는 완전 채식주의자에게 B12를 보충할 것을 권장합니다. 혀 아래 또는 경구 캡슐로 섭취할 수 있습니다. 에너지가 매우 부족한 일부 사람들은 비타민 B12 주사를 위해 의사에게 갈 수 있습니다.
Now, if you do choose to supplement a B vitamin, this is really important for you to understand. You never want to go to the grocery store or supplement store and choose an individual B. You want to make sure you get something called a B complex, which is going to provide all the different B vitamins in one tablet. This is important because science tells us that if you take an individual B vitamin for a long enough time, so more than a few months, which many of us do, it can start to deplete B the other important B vitamins in your body and brain, and you don't want that. So it's very important that you buy a B complex, not an isolated B, if you're going to supplement. Another thing to note is that if you have a healthy gut microbiome, then those different bugs that live inside our intestinal tract are capable of making certain B vitamins for us, like B2, B9, and B12. And then the other interesting thing that we're seeing in the literature is that the B vitamins work together with the omega-3s that we talked about earlier to improve brain and mental health. They love to work together.
비타민 B 보충제를 개별적으로 섭취하면 안 된다는 사실을 이해하는 것이 엄청 중요합니다. 하나가 높아지면 다른 비타민이 고갈되고 다른 문제가 발생할 수 있기 때문입니다. 고갈을 방지하기 위해 모든 비타민 B를 모을 수 있는 B 복합체를 취해야 합니다. 새로운 연구에 따르면 건강한 장내 미생물 군집이 있으면 장에 섭취하는 건강한 벌레가 일부 비타민 B를 생성할 수 있습니다. 일부 비타민 B는 오메가3과 함께 작용하여 두뇌와 정신 건강에 긍정적인 영향을 미칩니다. 마칩니다.
Vitamin D is a really interesting vitamin that's getting a lot of attention during COVID-19 because research is telling us that people who are deficient in vitamin D, if they catch COVID, they're tending to have more severe symptoms and also a longer run of COVID. So it's getting a lot of attention. In addition to its important roles with immune health and bone health too, actually, vitamin D is also very important for brain and mental health, as well as thyroid health. And I work a lot with thyroid too. Thyroid imbalance often looks very similar to mental health imbalance.
비타민 D는 면역 체계에 중요하며 최근 COVID-19로 많은 관심을 받고 있습니다. 결핍된 사람들은 증상이 더 심각하고 COVID의 가능성이 더 높은 것으로 보입니다. 기분과 정신 건강 그리고 갑상선 불균형이 종종 정신 건강 증상처럼 보일 수 있음에도 매우 중요합니다.
There are receptors for vitamin D in the same parts of the brain that are involved with depression. So scientists think that vitamin D and depression might live in the same regions of our brain, and vitamin D can really help us maybe alleviate depression. You can get two types of vitamin D. On the left here, I wrote a list for you of the fat-soluble vitamin D3 found in fatty fish, liver, butter, cheese, and eggs. And also there's plant-based vitamin D2 that's found in mushrooms, sea vegetables. Ergosterol is a type of, it's almost like a vegan cholesterol. And when sunlight hits ergosterol, it can make vitamin D2 in mushrooms and sea vegetables.
우울증과 관련된 뇌 부분에는 비타민 D 수용체가 있습니다. 비타민 D와 우울증은 뇌의 같은 부분에 산다는 것을 의미합니다. 비타민 D에는 두 가지 유형이 있습니다. 고기에서 찾을 수 있고, 예를 들면 기름진 생선, 김, 버터, 치즈, 계란, 그리고 또 식물에 찾을 수 있습니다. 예를 들면 버섯하고 해체류. 조류와 같은 식물성 식품에는 에르고스테롤이라는 식물성 콜레스테롤에 포함되어 있으며 햇빛에 노출됩니다.
Now, there's a lot of confusion around supplementing with vitamin D. And if you go to the health food store, it makes it really, really difficult because the fish oil and cod liver oil are found side by side. And so a lot of my clients get confused. So I just wanted to explain that to you really briefly. Fish oil is what you're going to get if you want to supplement with omega-3s. If you want vitamin D, then you can buy cod liver oil, which will give you vitamin A, D, and a little bit of those healthy omega-3s, EPA and DHA, or you can just buy a vitamin D3 supplement. Science tells us that D3 appears to be better absorbed by the body. So my recommendation is going to be a D3. We do have a lot of clients who are vegan or plant-based, and more companies now are selling vegan D3-based supplements, which is nice. So you can get it from different algaes, and companies are making it from that. Also keep in mind that vitamin D is called sunshine vitamin. So we want to get outside in the sunshine every day for 20 minutes, not in direct sunlight, but every day be outside before you put sunscreen on because your skin makes vitamin D3 and plant skin makes vitamin D2, like mushrooms and sea vegetables.
어휴와 대구 간유의 차이점을 이해하는 것이 중요합니다. 어휴에는 EPA와 DHA, 오메가3가 3이 있습니다. 대구 간유에는 비타민 A와 D, 그리고 약간의 EPA와 DHA가 있습니다. 연구에 따르면 D3는 신체에 더 잘 흡수되는 것으로 보입니다. 햇빛이 피부에 닿으면 D3를 합성합니다.
Magnesium is my absolute favorite mineral, and I work with it a lot with our patients to help them alleviate their anxiety. I work with it a lot at a higher dose to help people who are having a hard time sleeping. And in fact, the research tells us that magnesium deficiency might be the number one mineral deficiency in the Western world. And certainly in people who have sleep issues and anxiety, we see magnesium deficiency across the board. So this is a big, big one that I work with every day.
마그네슘은 그녀가 가장 좋아하는 미네랄이며 그녀는 고객이 불안을 관리하고 더 나은 수면을 취하도록 돕기 위해 마그네슘을 많이 사용합니다. 마그네슘 결핍은 사실 서구 세계에서 가장 흔한 미네랄 결핍일 수 있습니다.
Magnesium loves to live inside chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is the blood inside a plant. So if you look at the molecule of chlorophyll, inside every molecule, you'll see magnesium. And it's kind of similar to human blood, where we have a molecule called hemoglobin. And inside every molecule of hemoglobin, we have iron. So magnesium and chlorophyll is very much like the blood of plants. The best way to get magnesium is to eat dark leafy green vegetables, ideally every day. As well as there are other types of chlorophyll, not only green chlorophyll. So if you eat yellow, orange, red vegetables, you can get yellow, orange, and red chlorophyll too. Algae is another great source of magnesium, and a few fruits that I listed here for you. Not all fruit, but avocado, banana, figs, and raspberries are a good source of magnesium too. I always like to tell people, frozen is just as good as fresh. You don't need to worry about only buying fresh. Fresh can get very, very expensive, and also it's not available around the year. So frozen is okay. Now, a few foods that don't contain chlorophyll but are also high in magnesium are nuts and seeds, beans, and those same fatty fish that I taught you about earlier.
우리는 마그네슘을 항불안 광물이라고 부릅니다. 마그네슘은 염력소인 식물의 혈액 안에서 사는 것을 좋아합니다. 염력소는 식물의 혈액이며 모든 분자 내부에는 마그네슘이 있습니다. 혈액 또는 헤모글로빈의 모든 분자 내부에는 철이 있습니다. 염력소는 녹색 외에 노란색, 주황색, 빨간색 등 다양한 색상이 많습니다. 그리고 여기 가장 좋은 선택은 진화경 식품입니다. 예를 들면 짙은 잎이 무성한 녹색 채소, 빨간색, 주황색, 노란색 채소, 해조류입니다. 과일, 무화과, 아보카도, 바나나, 하고 라즈베리도 있습니다. 또한 두 가지 비염소 식품에서도 발견되는 게 견과류, 씨앗, 콩, 그리고 기름진 생선입니다.
If you're going to try a supplement for magnesium, it's really important for you to know which format is best. The best one to look for is the ones that end in 8, A-T-E. My personal favorites are magnesium citrate, and even better, but much more expensive. So if you're jumping up in price point, the best one is called magnesium glycinate. It's important to also keep in mind that magnesium, because while it's able to relax the mind and reduce anxiety and help you get a peaceful night's sleep, it also relaxes your bowels, okay? So the concern with magnesium is that if you take a very high dose immediately, it can cause loose stool, it can cause diarrhea. So you need to be careful. And if you look at the bottle, and I work with different doses depending on people's age and conditions, you want to take half the dose for the first week, and you build up the dose to the bowel tolerance to make sure that you stay regular. Now, you can also get chlorophyll supplements for magnesium, but there just isn't enough research behind them quite yet for me to really recommend it. Although, if you're interested, you can make a really fun at-home little chlorophyll shot. You can take a handful of fresh parsley or a handful of fresh cilantro. Both of these are very high in magnesium because they're dark leafy greens. And you blend them with a little bit of water, put them in the shot glass, and you take that. So you can do a little at-home magnesium shot.
어떤 마그네슘 보충제를 구입해야 하는지 아는 것은 혼란스러울 수 있습니다. 그녀가 가장 좋아하는 것은 마그네슘 글리시네이트입니다. 마그네슘은 모든 것을 이완시킵니다. 그것은 당신의 마음을 이완시키고 불안을 완화하고 건강한 수면을 촉진하는데 도움이 되며 또한 장을 이완시킵니다. 설사를 유발할 수 있으므로 장 내성을 키워야 합니다. 즉, 처음에는 원하는 용량의 전발을 복용하고 병의 최대 용량까지 작업해야 합니다. 엽록소 보충제와 내 건강에 대한 연구는 아직 충분하지 않습니다. 시도하고 싶다면 소량의 물에 신선한 파슬리나 고소한 줌을 넣고 엽록소 주사를 위해 혼합할 수 있습니다.
And last but not least, my favorite new area of research that I'm loving is the connection between the gut and the brain. And this term, psychobiotics, is a newish term. I didn't coin it, but a colleague of mine working at the University of Cork in Ireland, Dr. John Cryan, and his team came up with this word called psychobiotic. And I really wish that I had come up with this word because it means using... optimizing the gut health in order to optimize brain and mental health.
생균제는 그녀가 현재 가장 좋아하는 과학적 조사 분야입니다. 그녀가 이 단어를 만들지는 않았지만 그녀의 동료이자 친구인 아일랜드 코크 대학의 Dr. John Cryan이 만들었습니다.
And it turns out that this word, psychobiotic, is more than just psychobabble. This is a very important and very science-based, evidence-driven area of research. So what psychobiotics means is helping to target the brain and improve brain and mental health by improving the health of the gut microbiome. And the way that we do this is through probiotics and prebiotics. Probiotics, you may have heard of this word before, are your healthy, good gut bacteria. Pro means helpful, bio means alive. And prebiotics, you may have heard of or maybe not, it's a newer term. Prebiotics are special fibers found in certain foods that I'm going to teach you about. And these, it turns out, are the favorite food for the healthy microbes living in your guts. And newer research is starting to suggest that probiotics are very important, but maybe prebiotics are even more important.
이 용어는 장의 건강을 최적화하여 내 및 정신 건강 상태를 해결하는 것을 의미합니다. 프로바이오틱스는 건강과 웰빙을 촉진하는 장내 벌레의 건강한 종입니다. 나쁜 벌레와 균형이 맞지 않을 때 장면역 및 뇌의 불균형도 보입니다. 프리바이오틱스는 건강한 미생물이 먹고 싶어 하는 특수 섬유입니다.
Here are the top probiotic-rich foods. And I love all of these. And I see a few on here that hopefully you guys are very familiar with already. So the top probiotic-rich whole foods include miso, which is a fermented soybean, tempeh, another version of a fermented soybean, kimchi, delicious Korean delicacy, one of my favorite foods, actually. Real sourdough. I want to pause here and explain this to you. This is really important. If you're buying sourdough bread, you need to make sure you look at the label and it says active bacterial culture, or, you know, it says maybe the name of the bacteria, because a lot of the cheaper bread companies are using sourdough flavor. So that people think that they're buying sourdough bread, but it's not sourdough and it doesn't have any of those health benefits that real sourdough does. Another important probiotic food is raw sauerkraut, other fermented vegetables, yogurt, But please make sure if you're buying yogurt, buy plain unsweetened yogurt. And this is important because research tells us that if you're buying the pre-sweetened, delicious flavored yogurt, the probiotics inside that yogurt have already eaten that sugar inside the product and are no longer alive. So you need to start with unsweetened yogurt. And if you want, add your own sweetener, add your own fruit, but make sure that those probiotics, those microbes stay active in your yogurt. Other options are kefir, kombucha, which is a fermented tea product, and even you can buy now at the health food store, I even saw it at Costco too, is raw fermented salsa.
생존재가 풍부한 음식의 예를 들면 된장, 템페, 김치, 사워도우빵, 그리고 여기에서 주의할 몇 가지 사항이 있습니다. 사워도는 빵의 라벨에 액티브 컬처 또는 라이브 컬처라고 표시해야 합니다. 많은 회사에서 사워도우 맛을 사용하지만 건강상의 의점이 없습니다. 그리고 또한 잘게 썬 양배추, 다른 발효 야채, 그리고 요거트도 있고요. 근데 이 요거트는 무가당으로 구매해야 합니다. 원하는 경유 자신의 감미료 또는 과일을 추가하셔도 됩니다. 이것은 미리 감가를 가한 품종의 프로바이오틱스가 더 이상 살아있지 않기 때문입니다. 그리고 또 유산균 음료, 콤부차, 그리고 발효시킨 살사가 있습니다.
And here now are the prebiotic rich foods, which, as I said, are the favorite foods of your healthy gut microbes, your probiotics. You'll see that they're found in a variety of whole grains, fruits, vegetables, nuts and seeds. And one of my favorite sources of prebiotics, believe it or not, is cacao, dark chocolate. 65% and above is actually considered to be a good source of prebiotics. So here's the list for you to look at. And these are the best and researched prebiotic foods that you want to be eating every day.
프리바이오틱스는 건강한 장내 세균이 가장 좋아하는 식품인 특수 섬유임을 기억하십시오. 여기 예를 들면 고구마, 케일, 블루베리, 아보카도, 삼베씨와 치아씨, 호두, 콩, 키노아, 카카오, 익은 양파, 생양파, 익지 않은 아스파라거스, 민들레 나물, 생마늘, 익히지 않은 부추, 그리고 브로콜리와 콜리플라워가 있습니다.
Now, supplementing. A lot of people choose to take a probiotic supplement, and I think that it can be something really important you can use to optimize your brain and mental health, according to this research in psychobiotics. Now, a few things I want you to know if you're going to the supplement store and you're choosing a probiotic supplement. Number one, the most researched strains of probiotics to date are lactobacillus and bifidobacterium. So you want to make sure you look for those two names on the label. Second, you want to make sure that there are at least 10 billion active cultures in the bottle. And this is important because there's power in numbers. Not all of them are going to make it down to your intestines where they need to go to have their benefit. So you want to start with a big number to ensure that enough get to where they need to go. Now, the third point, make sure that there are at least 10 strains, 10 different types of probiotics in your supplement. And again, this is based on research showing that people who have healthy brains and strong, healthy, good mental health have a lot of different types of gut bugs in their intestinal tract versus people who have brain disorders and mental health diseases have lower diversity, less different types of these healthy gut bugs. So this is really, really important that the science is highlighting. Now, I prefer to recommend probiotics that you need to keep in the fridge because they don't like to be in the warm, hot environment. But some of my clients like to take their probiotics with them in their purse and take it when it's most convenient for them. So in that case, you want to make sure you purchase one that is coated. It's called enteric coating. Third-party testing is very important for me as a scientist. That means that somebody who doesn't work for the probiotic company comes and conducts independent research and shows that what the company is saying on the label is really, in fact, the reality. And I really like to look for products that start with real whole foods that are then fermented. And that's because in these types of products, you can get both the probiotics, and because it starts with whole foods, you can also get prebiotics from those healthy whole foods. Now, a lot of cheaper products will put in a prebiotic called FOS, which stands for fructooligosaccharide. A lot of my clients and research shows as well are struggling with this FOS. It can cause nausea, bloating, stomach upset. So I always say, stay away. If you see FOS on the label, put that one back. A lot of people ask me, when should I take my probiotic? And I always recommend to take it right before you go to bed.
고품질의 프로바이오틱스는 보충제를 선택하는 것은 매우 어려울 수 있으므로 다음은 몇 가지의 팁입니다. 많은 변종이 있지만 이 두 가지가 가장 잘 연구되었습니다. 숫자에 힘이 있다. 어떤 사람들은 그들이 가야 할 곳에 가지 못할 것입니다. 다양성은 다른 유형을 의미합니다. 우리가 알고 있는 것은 뇌와 정신 건강 문제가 있는 사람들이 건강한 사람들보다 장내 미생물의 다양성이 낮다는 것입니다. 어떤 사람들은 프로바이오틱스 보충제를 가방에 넣고 다니는 것을 선호합니다. 이 작업을 수행하는 경우 장용 코팅으로 보호되는 것을 구입하십시오. 제3자 테스트는 독립회사가 병에 담긴 내용이 실제로 포함되어 있음을 확인했음을 의미합니다. 전체 식품 기반의 제형이 있으며 프로바이오틱스도 포함되어 있습니다. FOS는 fructooligosaccharide의 약자로 메스꺼움, 위장장애, 팽만감을 유발할 수 있습니다. 그러니 멀리하세요. 밤에 자기 전에 프로바이오틱스 보충제를 섭취하는 것이 제일 좋습니다.
And just to summarize now, I hope that I was able to teach you just a few little things and help you understand that food and what you eat really, really plays a role and matters for your brain and mental health. Now, my former career, being in academics and being in science, we love to put band-aids to help people. And, you know, we're very good at band-aiding the problems. But now that I work more with nutrition, I think it's really important to go beyond the band-aid and actually try and look at what is the root cause? What is the big underlying issue that's then causing these symptoms in my patients, rather than just putting a band-aid on it and sending you home. I don't think that is the answer. So hopefully after tonight, you can start thinking about these five nutrients that can help improve your brain and mental health. And of course, just to summarize, these were your omega-3 fats, your B vitamins, vitamin D, magnesium, and then the psychobiotics, the pre and the probiotics.
요약하자면 음식은 두뇌와 정신 건강에 매우 중요합니다. 그녀는 서구의 과학 세계에서 왔기 때문에 문제의 반창고를 붙이는 데 능숙합니다. 그러나 반창고를 넘어 문제의 근본을 해결하는 것이 중요합니다. 이것이 오늘 밤 우리가 집중한 다섯 가지 영양소입니다. 오메가 3 패트, 비타민 B, 비타민 D, 마그네슘하고 생균제입니다.
And now I just want to say thank you very, very much for attending my talk tonight. If you are interested to get in touch with me, you can email us, you can call us, you can visit our website. I also encourage you to, on our website, sign up for our newsletter, which we send out twice a month. And it's full of new science-based articles that I write and my team writes on brain and mental health and nutrition. I have a team of chefs that works with me, and they're always creating new brain food recipes. And also, we send out information about all the different events that I host. I do quite a few events for the public every month. I'd like to let you know about our next one that might be of interest to you. On October 27th, I will be doing a workshop, a webinar, all about psychobiotics. So you'll learn a lot more about what the research is saying about the gut and how it impacts the brain and what you can do to optimize that. So thank you so very much for listening to me tonight.
오늘 저녁에 이 강연에 참석해 주셔서 감사합니다. 즐겁고 유익한 시간이 되셨기를 바랍니다. 여기에서 올샤에게 연락할 수 있습니다. 이 이메일로 통해서. 또한 이 웹사이트에서 뉴스레터에 등록할 수 있습니다. 뉴스레터는 새로운 기사, 두뇌 음식 레시피, 대중을 위한 최신 이벤트가 포함된 한 달에 두 번 발송됩니다. 10월 27일에 열릴 그들의 다음 워크숍은 장내 연결에 관한 주제로 여러분과 함께 하고 싶습니다. 감사합니다.
All right, so should we do some Q&A?
I think it, we start. Sophia, maybe you should ask them and any questions they do have.
질문 있으신 분은 저희 Q&A 박스 위에 넣으시면 됩니다.
Or they can speak out if they want to.
There is a question, there are two questions actually in chat.
Okay, here we go. First one. There are many diets that are popular and people swear by them. What do you think about diets? Sophia, do you want to translate that? And then I'll answer.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
That's okay. No.
다이어트를 엄청 잘 지키는 사람들이 있는데 그 살을 빼려고 하든지 아니면 더 건강해지고 싶은 사람들이 있습니다. 그래서 그 다이어트만 따라하는데 그거에 대해서 무슨 생각이 있습니까?
I have two answers about to that question. Number one, I think that some diets are like medication and should be used very short term to help address a problem. For example, I work with a lot of children who suffer from epilepsy, and we work with the ketogenic diet, and it's very serious and it's short term. So that's the first part of my answer, Sophia.
Oh, yeah, sure. 일부 다이어트는 약물과 같아서 단기간 사용해야 하는 게 좋습니다. 아까 제가 얘기한 것처럼 에필렙시 있는 애들은 키토 다이어트라고 그거를 엄청 짧은 시간 동안 씁니다.
And then the second part of my answer is yes, I think that I believe in certain types of eating. I believe in the Mediterranean diet, for example, that has so much research behind it. You know, I believe in a whole foods diet. I believe in a seasonal diet. So those sorts of things I believe in, but no, I do not believe in, you know, special fad trendy diets. They don't work.
특정 유형의 식사가 좋습니다. 예를 들면 지중해 식단에는 많은 연구가 있기 때문에 그 좋다고 생각하는데 뭐 다른 다이어트 막 먹는 거를 줄이는 건지 아니면 어떤 것을 안 먹는 것은 별로 좋다고 생각하지 않습니다.
And then we have another question from Chrissy. What is the difference between vitamin B and B12? And that's a great question. Vitamin B12 is one of the many B vitamins. And so if you see vitamin B complex on a label, then you know you're getting all of them. So there's many different ones.
비타민 B12는 많은 비타민 B 중에 하나입니다. 그래서 뭐 병에 비타민 B12가 써져 있다면 complex vitamin B라고 그걸 사는 게 좋습니다.
Another question from the presentation. What does it mean your skin makes vitamin D3?
자기 피부가 비타민 D3를 만드는 게 무슨 뜻입니까?
So that's another really good question. So on our skin, under the superficial layers of our skin, we have cholesterol. And when sunshine, when the UVB rays hit our skin, it can synthesize. The cholesterol and the sunshine come together and our skin can make D3. And that's why we recommend that you go outside for 20 minutes before you put on sunscreen so that you can make some natural vitamin D.
우리 피부에는 콜레스테롤이 있습니다. 그래서 UVB 광선이 우리 피부에 닿으면 합성될 수 있습니다. 그 뜻은 우리 피부 안에 있는 콜레스테롤과 그 햇빛에서 나오는 UVB 광선이 합쳐가지고 비타민 D3를 만든다는 뜻입니다.
Another great question. Is vitamin E good for your eyes?
비타민 E는 자기 눈에 좋습니까?
Yes. Yeah. Vitamin E is found to be very, very good for the eyes. But I would say that the research shows vitamin A is even better for your eyes, and especially for night vision. Some people suffer from something called night blindness. When it gets darker, you can't see anymore. Vitamin A supplements is what we work for with that.
비타민 E가 눈에 좋은 것은 맞습니다. 그러나 비타민 A는 눈에 더욱 좋습니다.
These are great questions. Does anybody else want to put a question in the chat, or you're welcome to come on and talk to me and ask me? Okay, here we go. Somebody else asked another good question. What about multivitamins? Do you recommend multivitamins or separate supplements?
멀티비타민을 먹는 게 좋습니까? 아니면 따로 먹을까요?
So that's a really, really good question, Young. Because our diets are so deficient for many of us living in this part of the world, a general multivitamin can be helpful to give you the basics. However, if you're sick and you have a neurological disease or you have a mental health condition, the multivitamin doses are not enough. So for a lot of my patients, we don't work with multivitamin. I have to do specific higher dose individual supplements. That's a very good question.
식이요법은 일반적으로 결핍되어 있으므로 여러 비타민이 도움이 될 수 있습니다. 그러나 만약 따로 어디 아픈 데가 있으면 비타민을 이제 집중해서 하나씩 먹는 게 더 좋습니다.
These are all great questions. Anybody else? Okay, we can stop sharing too.
Okay.
Yeah, if you have any further questions or want to talk to me directly, you're welcome to email me. I'm happy to answer any questions you might have as well.
There's one more question in chat.
Oh, okay. Oh, here we go. Okay. I have heard that Brazil nuts with selenium can help manage hypothyroid conditions. What do you think?
셀레늄이 함유된 브라질 너트가 갑상선 기능 저하 증 상태를 관리하는 데 도움이 될 수 있다고 들었습니다. 어떻게 생각하나요?
That's a great question. I work a lot with hypothyroid and hyperthyroid too, but Brazil nuts are very, very high in selenium, and selenium is a very important mineral that helps your thyroid build its hormones, T3 and T4. So yes, Brazil nuts. I always tell people four Brazil nuts every day to help manage hypothyroid. You know, of course, if you have hypothyroid diagnosed, you're going to need to take medication too, but this every day, four Brazil nuts can help, you know, maintain your thyroid health.
브라질 너트는 셀레늄 함량이 높습니다. 그래서 이것은 갑상선 기능 저하증을 돕습니다.
Very nice. Thank you. Anybody else? Final thoughts or questions? Anna, what do you think?
Oh, it's excellent. And whatever you say, that Lara is new world to me. Some of them is I don't understand. And especially medical world is me, and I'm not good about it. But I think we can understand more. I think a lot of people understand. And one thing I'm thinking about, how you can check what kind of vitamin I needed individually, different, I guess. How did you check?
Yeah, so I would be checking based on symptoms, right? So if you come to see us, we're going to ask you lots and lots and lots of questions, and we're going to try and see symptomatically. I mean, we can send you for blood work too. We can look at your B12, we can look at your iron, we can look at things. But a couple years ago, AHS stopped testing for vitamin D because they said everybody in Alberta is vitamin D deficient. So they're not testing anymore because all of us have vitamin D deficiency. So that one I can't test for anymore. I just assume that, yeah, you're deficient. Yeah, so there's certain ones. Yeah, there's certain ones I can send you for, and then I'm listening for symptoms.
Thank you so much. You're making me thinking. Yeah, thank you. Yeah. Anyway, at fortunately, I has a good health. So I never think about any other worry about my health wise. But yeah, making me think. Yeah, thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me, Anna. Yeah. Thank you for bringing me. And Sophia, thank you for your expert translation skills tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, Osha. And thank you, Sophia. Thank you, Farah. Thank you, Chris. Thank you so much. And thank you, City of Calgary, and support us. We can have a chance to learn different ways, and especially mental health. And then, as everybody, and this time we do have a frustration and our nervous and a lot of different things. But I think one at a time, don't worry about so much, everybody, and step by step, and we can get together and we can go through this time. Mm-hmm. I think it's going to be more we get together and more we can understand. I think we can get through the happily. And mm-hmm. Thank you so much. And 감사합니다, 여러분들. 여러분들은 잘 많이 아시는지 모르지만 저는 참 메디컬에 대해서 참 무식해요, 좀. 그래가지고 많은 것들을 저는 참 몰랐던 걸 오늘 많이 생각하게 만드네요. 부모님께서 주신 좋은 건강 때문에 저는 잘 여기까지 살아왔고 했는데 조금이라도 더 생각할 수 있는 기회를 주셔서 너무 감사하고요. 수고하신 여러분들께 너무 감사드립니다. 소피아, 그리고 수진이, and Farah, and Osha, and Farah, everybody가 너무 고생을 많이 하셨고, 또 우리가 웨비나가 앞으로도 많이 남아있으니까 여러분이 여성의 웹사이트 들어오셔서 한번 보시고, 체크하시고 언제인지 하고 또 항상 조인해 주시면 너무 감사드리고요. 많은 친구분들에게 연락해 주시면 감사하겠습니다. 이번 웨비나는 City of Calgary가 스폰서를 쓰고 여성회가 진행 중입니다. 그리고 그 강사들은 그 토픽에 맞게 전문가들을 모시니까 여러분들 많은 분들에게 선전도 많이 해 주시면 감사하겠습니다. 감사합니다. Thank you so much. Be happy too.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good night. Happy Thanksgiving. Bye.
Thank you.